Hey everybody, and welcome to the channel. Today's project, as you saw, is this Wright standard 36 inch rapid height commercial mower. What we're doing today is getting the pulleys and this retainer off of the spindle so that I can get the parts that I need for the spindles and rebuild them. This unit has 1100 hours on it and needs the got some play and some slop in the spindle, so we're going to get that taken care of before the spring onslaught comes upon us. And just going to bring you along and take a look at, show you a few tricks that I've learned on how to do this. There's the pulley over there. So it can be a little bit of a daunting of a task, but the biggest part's right here. Thankfully, Wright has carriage bolts right down here, so you just need to, once we get the pulleys off of both sides, we'll go ahead and just run some PB blaster or whatever underneath and pull your blades off, pull the bolts out, and then we should be able to loosen and lower our blade spindle. So here is the side I already have done. So you see that there? This part right here will slides over. It's got a little key, and it slides right here in that slot. We're going to get this cleaned up before we put it back on. And the pulley actually will go down like this, and then you'll slide this part over your hub there, and then you'll pull it up and you'll tighten it with these screws right here. They'll go through right here and then into the pulley here, just to keep everything together. There is a little bit of a trick to that. I saw a great video on that I hope to link to this, and we'll take you along and see how it turns out. Alright, so we'll see how well this goes. Anyways, you'll take your these two bolts that go in through these sleeve holes. You'll take those and you'll screw them in right over on the threaded portion of this part. They are 9/16. Went ahead and got a deep well 1/4 inch socket. Make sure they start here. We'll probably end up getting a as they go in farther and drop the pulley, we'll what am I trying to say? Anyway, we're gonna need to hold this, so I'll probably get a crowbar and hold that in place. But a couple things I've noticed on the couple videos I watched is to measure a couple things. Notice the height of this part in relation to our shaft. You've got just a little bit of a ledge right here, and also notice the gap here. With this part right here, what has happened is that it has expanded, and that is what's holding the pulley in place. So we're gonna drive these bolts down. That's gonna push the pulley off of this part, and then we'll be able to get this off slowly with a puller and go from there. But we need to make sure that for the reverse, when we put stuff back together, and we line up this part about right here, and that we leave this amount of space for return so that our belt rides correctly. We're not, you know, it's not skipping off or wearing out a belt prematurely. So I'm going to double check a measurement there. It looks like almost like 1/4 inch. Double check. Make sure. Well, I think it's actually less than 1/4 inch. Wait, look. Try to make sure we get that. One thing you can do is also take pictures so that when you put it back together, you've got a little bit better idea what you're looking at. So I got my picture. That should help out. Alright, we got a crowbar, and we need it. I sprayed this with, I started this project a couple days ago, and so I sprayed everything with PV Blaster, so hopefully that's gonna help. We'll see. Just work either side a couple times, and then switch sides and just keep the balance. You'll feel it gradually, the pulley, you'll feel it gradually start to drop. All thing I need to do is set the brakes on the mower. There we go. Should help us a little bit. Go ahead and set our look real close, you should be able to see the height difference here compared to how it started out. So making progress. It's slow, but we're making progress. So we'll get these off. Now, one reason we're going to rebuild is that brand new spindles are $200 a piece. Now with the age of the machine and how good a shape it's in, that's probably not a bad deal. But I thought, well, I believe I can rebuild each spindle for about $25. We'll get our parts, go to the store and find out. But that's what a friend of mine said at my local dealer. So we're going to find out how that works. So, and this is definitely a one of our favorite units. This machine really gets a lot of work. We've used it in muddy conditions. We've used it for 3, 4, 5 feet tall grass. It's seen a lot of heavy duty menacing work. So just trying to keep up with it for the summer. Ah, got something popping there. I don't know if we've for breaking a bolt. I hope that's not the case. That will not be fun. I'm gonna pull the camera back here. It was very simple. Now there's a chance I've read about breaking these bolts off. I hope that's not what's gonna happen. If that's what happens, you're gonna see it first. We're gonna try to back it off here without breaking it. Thankfully that didn't break off. We'll try to drive the other side down a little bit. Now where I really need the spray is down here on that shoulder. Let's see what it does. Obviously, we don't want to strip the threads here either. You can hear it stressing. Break a loose, it feels like, just take your time. Also, when we put everything back together, we'll treat it to a heavy dose of anti-seize, of course. But take a look again and see how we've made an impact on that spacing. There we go. So I'll just drop off right there. So that's all you need, folks. There actually is a shoulder, well, it's just a mark there that kind of gives an idea where to line that back up. We'll try to get these bolts out here. Now, the fun part will be putting our puller on here and trying to get this off. See how well that works there. So that's for the pulley. Now for this part, which is kind of tricky looking. Alright, we're going to turn the camera off for a second so we don't scratch anything up.